My name is Alan Heft. I'm a biologist with the Maryland Department of Natural Resources Inland Fisheries Division. I am basically working on cold water fish issues for the state with an emphasis on brook trout here in Western Maryland. We're working here today in the Upper Savage River, which is a special native brook trout management area. And we are radio tagging fish so that we can follow their movements to determine where they go seasonally, particularly in the summer months when the water gets warm.
I'm Matt Sell. I'm the brook trout specialist for Maryland DNR Inland Fisheries. Part of my job is pretty much studying, researching, and helping to make management decisions on behalf of our only native trout. You can look at temperature, where water's being ponded in a watershed, or the canopy isn't closed, the water's warming up too much. You know that you have an indication because brook trout just won't be there. Where do these fish go? How long do they stay there? Do they come back? In order to answer those questions, we implemented this radio tagging study last year.
Once we collect the fish, we will put the fish in a bucket, hold the fish until it's time to tag it, and then we go through our tagging process where we anesthetize the fish, we get lengths, we get some other body condition indices from it, and then we'll go ahead and do the tagging process. And the tagging process itself is very minimal. We'll make a small incision on the body of the fish, slide the tag in, close the incision with sutures, and then the fish will recover in a bucket and we let it go. And then we'll just continue to track these fish. Matt Sell, our biologist, will walk 15, 20 miles a day sometimes, tracking these fish throughout the watershed. We've lost over half of our native brook trout waters through the development and damage to the streams. And the last stronghold in Maryland is out here in the Savage River watershed. It's one of the few places remaining in the Mid-Atlantic where we have a large river system that is still connected to its original tributaries. There's no blockages, no dams, and these fish can swim from one end of the river all the way up into the headwater of some tributary 20-some miles away.
First order streams make up 90% of the stream miles in the state of Maryland, or more, and this is where it all begins. If you can begin with these headwater areas, protect these areas, have the water quality coming out of here as good as what we can, then as it moves downstream, it has a better chance as it flows on towards the bay.
Brook trout are kind of like the canary in a coal mine. When you have brook trout, you know that you have good water, clean water, good habitat, a protected watershed. When you lose the brook trout, you know you have a real problems beginning in your watershed. So we're working real hard in Maryland to try and save the brook trout that we have left.